And we prayed with her. Went back for another ultrasound the week after, and he's a baby with a heartbeat. It's incredible, isn't it? And there's many, many testimonies I can share, but even with Aiden, little Aiden, he was in my tube and that topic pregnancy. And I really had in my spirit when I conceived him that, sorry, Aiden, that to pray protection of that, and I continued to pray and pray. And I was threatened. I was rushed to the doctors with all the symptoms, and they said, you've got every symptom of an ectopic pregnancy. Rushed for an ultrasound, and they said the same thing, that every symptom you have is an ectopic pregnancy. So we were fortunate that we had time alone. We had Caitlin with us, and we just prayed and said, God, we thank you that it is not your plan for us to miscarry this child. And we ask that you move this baby to the womb. And I felt this heat in the side of my body, and it moved down, it was throbbing, and it stopped. So by the time I had the scan, all the pain, the cramping had stopped, and it's determined that he's here today. And just another thing I wanted to say, just through the word of God, speaking what God's word says over the facts of what you're feeling. I mean, to be in a threatened miscarriage situation, which I'd also experienced with Caitlin, you've got all the symptoms of death. You've got all the symptoms of sickness and disease in your body. But when you rebuke the fear and you continue to say, no, my God says, and you begin to speak God's word, like I was saying before, the word of God penetrates your body and it brings health, it brings life. And with Aiden, I had this real thing in my gut to pray for protection of Down syndrome. And so I began to speak the word of God over him when he was in my womb. And like just little scriptures like, God, you know, he will be fearfully and wonderfully made. And Psalm, I think, 138, that the Lord will perfect that which concerns his baby. He will not forsake the work with his own hands. And I had this thing all along, you know, to pray for that. And then one night I thought, I'm going to convert this, because it wasn't fear, but it was like something I could not quite be on it. And I prayed and I sought God and I felt something break. And then that was it for me. At 12 weeks, I had a blood test and they said, you've got very high reading for abnormalities. And I said to my doctor, look, you know, I wouldn't abort the baby anyway, so, you know, I just, you know, this baby's fine, forget it. And so when he was born, they took him off the tests and they came back and they said, look, we've got to do more tests on your son. So they took him off and he was gone for a couple of hours and they came back and they said, look, we need you to sit down. And so I sat down on the bed and they said, look, we just want to let you know that we think your son has Down syndrome. And immediately I felt this peace and I saw the Holy Spirit gave me the vision of when I prayed in my bed, because that night I was praying in my bed and I saw myself looking down at myself when I broke that in prayer. Mm-hmm. And I knew, and I said within myself, I knew, Lord, you know, there's nothing on him. And they showed me the palm of his hands, and you can all have a look. Where we have two curved lines, Aiden has a single line, and it's called a Syrian crease. And only babies with Downs have that. Mm. Or it can be hereditary. So he had this crease in his hand. And I said, look, I know he's fine. So he went through all these battery tests, and it's perfect. There's nothing on him. I know.